unlock the hidden power of your data with Power Query in MS Excel. In this video, I'll show you how to effortlessly clean, transform, and combine data from multiple sources. With Power Query, you can streamline your data preparation process and save valuable time for more insightful analysis. Join me as we dive into the world of Power Query and supercharge your Excel skills. Before moving on to the tutorial, you can access the workbook in the description box. Once you click the link, it will take you to the Google Docs. From there, you can click on the file drop-down and download the files. This is Mir Salon and you're watching Growth Mindset. This is the folder where I have kept my data. It contains the data for the year 2021 and 2022. This is the same folder where I will be keeping my future files, and I will be combining the data from all the files in this folder and performing some calculations and automating it through Power Query so I don't have to repeat the same task every time. Let's go into our file and see what the file contains. Now, once we are in the file, I can see over here that I have few columns in the beginning which contains the identification, that is store, product, currency and customer identification. Then we have the name column, but over here in the name column, once I receive the file, it always contains the last name first and the first name second. So I want to reverse the order and keep both the first and the last name in separate columns. Then I have the continent column, which seems pretty much okay to me. Then moving on to country column, here I can see that it contains the country name, and then after a dash it contains the state name, and lastly it contains city. So I want three of these: country name, state and city name, in separate columns. And we are going to see in a bit how we can do that and how we can automate that. This is the ordering date, this is the due date, delivery date. These columns seems pretty much fine to me. Now moving on to other columns, here in the quantity column, this quantity should be in units rather than currency, so we are going to see that how we are going to fix this as well. Unit price, unit discount, unit cost, net price seems pretty much okay. Now I want to make further calculations where I want to calculate gross profit per unit and gross profit in total, but this sheet does not have that, and I will be performing those calculations in Power Query. Once I have Excel sheet opened up, I can go in the data tab, and here in the data tab I can go in the section that says get and transform. I click on new query, and here in the drop down it gives me further options from workbook, from CSV file, from XML, text, or from the folder. We can attach the folder, and whatever files are going to be in the folder are going to get pulled in this Excel workbook. Exploring further, we have other options that we can pull in the data from databases that include Access, SQL, Oracle, and many other options. We can pull in the data from Azure, from other sources, and there's a whole lot of options available over here. And here we can see, interestingly, that we can pull in the data from Facebook as well. But for now, we're going to go in from folder. We want to pull in the data from folder. I click onto this. We can browse the folder by clicking over here, or I have just copied the path, so I am pasting the path over here. I press OK, and now it is processing. Here I can see that it has year 2021 and year 2022 files appearing over here. It is telling me the folder path from where it is picking up the data from. If we go down, we have different options over here of edit, cancel, load. If you're going to click on this drop down, so it is going to load the data and load two options, but we will be exploring this combine option. Once we go in the combine, we see that we have further three options: combine and edit, combine and load combine and load to. Here in the second last and the last option, we can combine and load our data, but we will not be able to edit it. But if we are going to select combine and edit, it is going to let us combine both of the files, that is year 2021 and year 2022 file, and at the same time we will be able to edit it. So I click on this, and now it is evaluating the query and pulling in the data from the folder. Now it opens up another window which says select the object to be extracted from each file. The file that we have specified, that is year 2021 and 2022. So it is asking that from those workbooks which file we want to select. As an example file, we are going to keep the first file, but if we go in the drop down, we can select 2021, 2022. Both of the files have same columns organized, so I'll keep the first file. And now I will be clicking on the sales worksheet in the workbook, and here I have the preview from the workbook. Before I click on to OK, on the left side we can see that we have this option skip files with error. If your file is going to have any errors and we have checkmarked it, so it is going to skip it. For now, our file does not have any error, so I keep it unchecked. I press OK. And now it is evaluating query once again. And here we can see that it has pulled in the data from both of the sheets. On the top, like in Excel, we have the ribbon where we have the Home tab, Transform, Add Column and View. We are going to explore each in a bit. On the left side, here we can see that there are a bunch of queries that it has automatically run through, so we have all of those queries listed over here. On the right side, here we have applied steps. Applied steps show the recording of each of the steps that we are going to take within this workspace. In the center, it contains all the data that has been pulled in from the two workbooks. So we will be going through all of the data and make necessary changes. This first column contains the source name of the file, so we don't need it. I right click onto it, and here I just click on remove, and it removes the column. I'm pretty much fine with the store ID, product ID and other ID column. And here in the name column, as we saw earlier, that the last name is appearing first and the first name is appearing second. So how we can do that? We can see that our data contains a comma in between and a space between the first and the second names. So while keeping my cursor over here on name, I right click, and here down it gives me an option of split column, and I will split it by the delimiter. And here I have the drop down. I will go in custom drop down, and now I want to split it with a comma. I will put a comma over here and a space and press OK. And here I see that now I have the second name over here, that is the last name, and the first name appearing over here. So I can just click over here in the name one, and this is the last name. I click out of it, it has changed the name, and now this name two, I click again over here, and this is the first name. I again click out, so the names have been changed. Now I want to move the first name ahead of the last name, that is I want to place it after the customer ID. I just click it and drag it over here, and now the first name is appearing before the last name, and both of the names are appearing in separate columns. Now I am pretty much fine with the continent column, but here again in the country column, we saw earlier also that the country name, state and the city name are appearing in the single column. How we can split that into three different columns? As we saw earlier, that I kept my cursor over here, right click onto it, and here it gave me an option for splitting the column. But this time I will go in the home tab, and here it gives me split column option. I click over here, press by delimiter, and again we will go over here. The custom is selected already, so I will go with the custom. And if you see over here that the country name has a space, then a dash, then a space, and then the state name, and same is over here. that it has space, dash, space, and then the city name. So I will be putting a space, dash, and a space for separating it. Press OK. And now the country, state, and the city names have been separated. But there is again one problem, that the names of the column are not very much descriptive. It has turned the country column into country 1, country 2, and country 3. Again, we click over here and I just make the first column country, second column is state, and third column is city. So we are pretty much done with it. If I want to reduce the width of the column as an Excel, we can just drag it and reduce the width. I'm fine with the order date, due date, and delivery date columns, but I want to calculate the lead time, that is the difference between the delivery date and the order date, to see that how many days it takes for the customer to order and receive its final product. So for that, first I will select the delivery date by clicking on delivery date, press Control key, and then click over here on the order date to select it. And here I go in add column, and I have an option over here of date. So in this drop down I have this option subtract days. I click on this and now it has subtracted days, but the name of the column is not appropriate. It is showing me subtraction. Now I will change the name again because it is not descriptive. Days to deliver, and I want to keep it along the other columns, that is after the delivery date. So I click and drag it over here, and now we can see that it is placed next to delivery date. Now moving on to our next columns, we can see over here that I have the quantity columns. If I click on this 1, 2, 3 numerics over here, so it shows me that what it is. So we have the whole number over here, so we have different options over here, and we can change all of these options. For instance, in unit price I have this decimal number. I want to change it to currency, and likewise I will be changing all of these other columns to currency as well, because these are cost, discounts, and unit prices. So these will all be in currencies. Now I want to make further calculations. I want to have subtraction of net price from the unit cost, so I will click on this, press Control key, and then click on this, and here I will go and subtract it. So this is gross profit per unit, and lastly I want to have the total gross profit, so I will be again clicking over here, and the quantity sold, and this time I want to have multiplication, and this column is going to be total gross profit. My data is pretty much ready, and I performed all of the calculations that I want to perform each time I receive the file. But here I can see over here, well, this row contains all of the information in zero. So let's see that what it contains. Well, here we can see that this has been the order that has been cancelled. So we don't want that. We go in the drop down for filtering it, and this is the text. So we are going to scroll all the way down, and here we can see the text is at bottom. I uncheck it, press OK, and now it has removed all such orders that were cancelled. One final thing to look at, we have whole list of steps that we have performed over here. So here we can see that the last step we performed for the cancelled order was filtering, so it is showing that we have filtered it. But if we are going to click over here in this step, which was previous to filtering, so it will show the row that contained the cancelled order. So it is going to show me the step before the filtering step. If I scroll back over here, so you can see over here that it is showing me, but if I click on the next step, so it has removed the filtered row. Now once all the things have been done, I go in the home tab, and here I have an option of close and load. I click over here and it gives me further option, close and load. So I click on this, And now it has retrieved all of the data over here. We have the workbook queries over here. If I click on this, right click over here, go and show the peak. Here it shows me all the data that is coming from the workbooks. And more importantly, to look that it shows the data sources as well. So it is showing me paths to the folder from where it is picking in the data. Now once we have this data set appearing over here, so it contains all of the data from both of the workbooks. Now we are going to further analyze it. I go in the insert tab, pivot tables, and here I have an option where I can either make the pivot table in the existing sheet, or I can just make the pivot table in another sheet. I will go with the new worksheet. Over here it shows new worksheet. I press OK. Now here we can build the pivot table. For instance, select the countries in the row. I want the quantities, so I put it in values, and then I go for the order date. I put it in rows. So here we can see that we have all of this data appearing over here. We have these icons over here. Either we can expand it quarter wise, and if we click it again, we can collapse it. So we have all of this data over here. Now one thing to notice over here, that once I have an additional file in my folder, we can see that previously I had year 2021 and year 2022. Now I have an additional file with the same file format, and it contains the similar data but of the year 2023. So how we can pull in the data automatically, and whatever steps we performed earlier, we don't have to perform all of those steps. I just have the file in the folder from where it pulls in the information. I go here in the data, and here in data I have an option of refresh all. I click over here, and now we can see that previously it was having the data of 2021 and 2022, and now it contains the another year, that is 2023. It has performed all of those steps that we performed earlier automatically, and it has pulled in the data. So we have all the data over here. Well, that's it. If you like the content, then make sure that you hit the like button, subscribe, share, and give your comments down below in the comment section. Your comments act as a navigation tool, so make sure that you can give your suggestions for any topics that you want me to create videos on. Thanks for joining me. See you soon. Take care and bye-bye.